Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the presentation of the colors by the Long Branch High School Air Force Junior ROTC.
Ms. Powers, Mr. Moore, and Mr. Whitmore. And without the dedication, passion, and talents of your fellow students, we would not be here. They collaborated with teachers and each other to create a feast for your eyes and ears. They will share variations of their interpretation of the community they yearn to live in, ways in which they endeavor to understand one another, and what makes them hopeful. Thank you.
Thank you all for being here today, and a special thanks to Sam for all her work, hard work, and diligence to make sure that this program is gone on with the success. So enjoy, and thank you.
now I am happy to welcome Ms. Powers and the high school chorus performing two songs. I'll Be There and Don't You Worry About a Thing.
Thanks.
And now, to follow that amazing performance, Jonte Amatraden reciting Patricia Kazoo's Dark Girl, Light Intentions.
With ideas like stars in the sky. When they are ridiculed, I struggle not to weep. The stars are enveloped and sealed by the dust of my skin. Ideas shine through and now they are seen clearly. As my packaging is opaque in comparison, yearning to be golden, ideas invisible and unbelievably light. I have learned it is hard to see blinding stars without the depth of night.
I have a great video to show you now. Human Family by Maya Angelou.
I note the obvious differences in the human family.
Some of us are serious, some thrive on comedy.
Some declare their lives are lived as true profundity,
and others claim they live the real reality.
The variety of our skin tones can confuse, bemuse, delight.
Brown and pink and beige and purple, tan and blue and white.
I sailed upon the seven seas and stopped in every land.
I've seen the wonders of the world, not yet one common man.
I know 10,000 women called Jane and Mary Jane.
But I've not seen any two who really were the same.
Mary twins are different, although their features jive. And lovers think quite different thoughts while lying side by side.
We love and lose in China. We weep on English moors.
And laugh and moan in Guinea. Thrive and spin ashore.
We seek success in Finland, are born and die in Maine. In minor ways we differ, and in major we're the same.
I note the obvious differences between each sort and type, but we are more alike, my friends, than we are unalike.
We are more alike, my friends, than we are unalike. We are more alike, my friends, than we are unalike.
I would now like to introduce Vanessa Paquette reciting Indelible Impressions.
Indelible Impressions. She was my constant motivator, an example of a joyous existence. She imbued my laughter with her spirit. My thirst for knowledge can only be explained by her respect for it. As a child, I revered her. As a teen, she baffled me. As an adult, I understood her game plan. Missing her presence in all its unique manifestations, I realized what an indelible gift she's given me.
I'm very excited to introduce a former graduate, Felipe Estrada. His message is powerful.
So, go to school. How's everybody doing this morning? So, all the teachers that have taught me, I seriously appreciate all that you've done. Thank you for not ever giving up on me. I know I may have not been the best student, but I thank God that I had the teachers and the staff and the amazing people that I met in this middle school through this district to help me get to where I am today. I thank you so much. I'd like to give a round of applause to the people. Thank you so much. The title of my message today is called, What is Your Why? Keep that thought in mind. Keep that question in mind. What is your why? I find that life is interesting. There's only 24 hours in a day, about 4 weeks in a month, and 12 months in a year. And 9 months out of the year, you all are here. You guys are in school. You guys go to the same school to do the same thing at the same time, and you walk through the same hallways to get to the same classes, to sit down at the same seat with the same people and listen to the same teachers. But why? What is your why? Take a few seconds real quick and ask yourself, why do I do what I do? The same way you're asking yourself why is the same way those who are involved in the civil rights movement ask themselves why. Martin Luther King Jr., most famous for the I Have a Dream speech, asked himself why. Harriet Tubman, a leading abolitionist before the Civil War who escaped slavery, asked herself why. Malcolm X, a courageous advocate for black rights, asked himself why. W.E.B. Du Bois, the creator and founder of the NAACP in 1909, asked himself why. Rosa Parks, who refused to move from her spot on the bus that eventually started the Montgomery bus boycott, asked herself why. Frederick Douglass, one of the most famous intellectuals of his time, asked himself why. They all did the same thing because of the same struggle and asked themselves the same question. Why? So if they ask themselves why, I'm pretty sure we've asked ourselves why sometimes. What is your why? Here, I have a couple for you. Why can't you be successful? Why can't you try your hardest at school? Why not be a leader instead of a follower? Why not be honorable or high honorable? Why not be the best student that you can be? Why not make a difference in today's society and in the world we live in today? Why? Because there's power in the youth. There's hope in the youth. There's value in the youth. And you guys right here, right now, can make a change and make a difference, and you can make the world a better place. You got the power of a new generation in your hands. Everybody look at their hands real quick, just like this, just like this, just like this. Everybody look at their hands real quick. See, I got the power, I got the future in my hands. Come on now, am I doing all right? Come on now, talk back to me. For what they are now. Just look at what they can be in the future. See, past all the stuff that they do now, look what they can be in the future. That's what matters. That's where they're going. That's who they are. Potential. Future advocates for the world. Look at them for who they can be and who they will be. Because these kids right here in these seats are special. Everybody give themselves a round of applause. You guys are special. Everybody in this room is special. Come on now, talk back to me now. Come on now, talk back to me now. Come on now. Come on now, man. Don't try to play my kids up because I came to this. I'm from the same spot they from. I'm from the same streets they from. I'm from the same hood that they're from. Don't judge them. Who are you to judge them? Because you wasn't perfect all your life. Come talk back to me now. That's where I'm coming from. Talk back to me now. But let me tell you something. Middle school kids, let me tell you something. You ready? It's not going to be easy. It's not going to be easy. You're not going to be happy all the time. You're human. You'll get discouraged. And you'll end up asking yourself why again, in a different way this time. You'll ask things like, why don't people love me? Why am I always getting bullied? Why am I always being sent to in school? Why am I always getting kicked out of talk back to me now? Come on now. Why am I always getting kicked out of class? Why am Come on now. Should have drunk some water before I came up here. But you ask yourself, why am I not good enough? Why me? And when you guys get to that point of self-doubt, stop it. Don't go any further. When you guys begin to doubt yourself, don't even do it. Because you're not where you're going to be in the future right now. Your kids, you're developing, you're growing. And once again, you're going to be special. You're special right now. Just remind yourself that there is a reason why you are in school. Just remember your why. Our elders who were involved in the civil rights movement had you guys in the back of their minds. I'm sure they wanted to give up. Am I right, Ms. Bowles? I'm sure they wanted to give up. Come on, Mr. Brown, you in there? I'm sure they wanted to give up. Come on now. But they kept falling back on their why. And because of that, they kept protesting. They kept boycotting. They kept marching. They kept gathering. And they kept going through the door. Than they did. They put their lives on the line because you guys are special. They were on a mission to make a way and provide hope for the next generation. Because once again, I'm gonna keep saying it, and you're gonna keep hearing me saying it until you get it in your mind. Don't ever think you're not special, because you're special. And you know what? You wanna know what? That we all wanna see you guys become successful. Everybody wants to see you grow. Everybody wants to see you come out on top. And if nobody does, I want to see you come out on top. I want to see kids like me make it. I want to see kids from Long Branch make it and be something that people say they can. I want to see the growth. Come on, talk back to me now. Shout out some noise in here. Talk back to me now. Come on, come on, let me, do y'all want me to finish? Come on now. So you guys, wonder why teachers are so hard on you? Come on, Ms. Bowles, why are teachers so hard on the kids? Because they want to see them be successful. You wonder why your parents are always on your back? It's because they want to see you be successful. You wonder why your coaches are always yelling at you? Because they want to see you be successful. Why am I even here right now? Because I truly, from the bottom of my heart, want to see you be successful. Talk back to me if you can. Talk back to me if you can. Talk back to me. I feel like I'm in church right now. I'm preaching at my church right now. I'm almost done. You want me to finish? I'm almost done. In like 2 more minutes, I promise you. 2 more minutes, that's all I need. You can time me if you need to. So, I came here. Some say I'm crazy for even coming here. I have midterms this week. I have papers due this week. I have projects due this week. I gotta go to class later on today. I'm in college, I'm a freshman in college. It's tough, but you guys are gonna get there. I believe in you. But what I'm trying to say is my time is as thin as it's ever been. I got so much to do in so little time. But I came by because I have a passion for the youth. I have a passion for Long Branch. I have a passion for you all right here. I have a passion for the staff right here. This is where my heart is. This is where my passion is. And that is why I came by. When I was young, like you guys are right now, people, older kids in this community helped me out. Adults in this community helped me out and helped me grow as an individual. So I believe it's my job now. It's my time now. It's the youth's time now to help out younger kids that want to make it just like I want to make it. I'm a kid that wants to make it just like you. I'm a couple years older than you, but I want to make it just like you. And that's the reason I came by. That is my why. What is your why? Thank you.
America again. Let America be America again.
Stop living and thinking so small, will we be free?
to see ourselves and each other for who we truly are.
History Month Assembly.